I don't know what the end result of the cloning would be, but it would kind of like scare me a bit.
We wouldn't have him if we cloned him.
Yeah, I'd never feel like it's the same dog.
But I still love them because I know that every cell in that body came from that original pet.
This is Waffles. She's my first dog ever, and even though I only got her about a year ago, it's already breaking my heart that someday she's gonna die. But what if she didn't have to? What if Waffles could live forever? Welcome to Technality. I'm Alex Melke, and today we're diving into the very real world of pet cloning. Okay, so there are three things that I need to figure out. First, how does cloning Waffles work? Second, how much is something like this gonna cost me? And third, why do some people think that cloning is a bad idea? The first thing we need to dive into is how cloning works. And you can't talk about cloning without bringing up the godmother of clones, Dolly. In 1996, Dolly was the first mammal to be successfully cloned from an adult sheep's cell, the first living thing to get a second chance at life. But it took 277 attempts before scientists managed to create a single Dolly that lived till adulthood. That's a lot of eggs to break for one omelet. But over the next 20 years, cloning technology became a lot more stable. And by 2016, South Korean company Suam Biotech was producing 500 clone animal embryos a day.
Okay, so how does cloning work?
Step one, you grab the cell nucleus from your pet. This is the part of the cell that has all their DNA, and inject it into a blank donor egg from another donor dog or cat. Step two, the egg is grown in a lab into a full embryo. Step three, the embryo is then implanted into the womb of a surrogate mother. And step four, she gives birth to your new best friend.
That's the simplified version of it. The actual science would sound like straight gibberish to both you and me, but that's the gist of it.
So the next question is, how do I actually get Waffles cloned? Today, right now, and for how much? This is Melaine Rodriguez. She works for Viagen, and they are the leading pet cloning firm in the world. Melaine's background in science started her off in Viagen's cell culture lab almost 14 years ago.
How many clones do you think that Viagen has created?
We started out 20 years ago cloning livestock. So we have cloned thousands of cows and pigs and horses. And then we started cloning pets in 2015. It's in the hundreds. Yeah, probably close to 1,000. Just about every week, we'll be cloning dogs. And so we have births of puppies just about every week.
When Viagen began cloning pets, the number one question they got was, just how much like my original pet will the clone be?
There's definitely a genetic component to personality. And it can be stronger in some clones than in other clones. And so I've gotten a variety of feedback. You know, some clients will say the personality is exactly the same. Some will say it's kind of the same, but they're their own dog. And some will say, well, they look a lot alike, but they don't. There's a different personality, but I still love them because I know that every cell in that body came from that original pet.
What about in terms of the clone's health? Are clones more likely to get sick?
So a cloned animal is going to be just as healthy as any conventionally bred dog. So if the original dog had any illness or disease that had a genetic component, then the cloned dog is going to have that potential. Those genes are there and they may develop that illness or disease at some point in its life. So there is some counseling that's involved in making sure that the clients know what to expect and they have a realistic expectation.
What about legally? Are clones still considered animals or are they things?
I mean, yeah, they are legally animals. There are the registries like the AKC that registers show dogs. They will not register a cloned dog at this point in time. And I think a lot of that is because their question is, who is the parent? And in reality, the parent of the clone is the parent of the original dog. But it's something that they can't really grasp, you know, like, how do we do that technically and legally? So they just opted, well, we're just not going to register clone dogs.
The cost to clone your pet isn't cheap. If I wanted to clone Waffles today, it would run me $50,000. A cat clone is a bit more affordable at just $30,000. In 2018, Barbara Streisand cloned her dead dog Samantha, and Simon Cowell has said that he's dropping over $200,000 to clone his three Yorkshire Terriers. This is definitely above most people's budgets.
Clones may have gotten a bad rap from Hollywood with movies like Arnold Schwarzenegger's Sixth Day or video games like the Metal Gear Solid series.
So what is it about clones that makes people feel a little uneasy? Well, for one thing, the pet you walk in with might not necessarily be the pet you walk out with, no matter how much they look alike.
Kelly Anderson cloned her cat 4 years after she died. These two cats are identical copies of each other, but other than that, Kelly says that they have completely different personalities. There are also some animal welfare organizations that are against pet cloning, citing scientific studies that claim cloned animals are more prone to disease. The process doesn't always take either, and could mean needing lots of pregnancies that could be rough on a surrogate mother.
And then there's the possibility that you end up with 4 copies of the same dog. How do you choose which one is yours?
I'll be honest, I'm still pretty split down the middle on the idea of cloning even after all this information, so I'm going to turn to a couple of new pet owners to see what they think about it.
Would you ever consider cloning Biggie?
That's a no-brainer. Yeah, look at this face. Look at this squishy face. It's a yes for me.
I love Biggie. He's amazing. But I just feel like I would maybe be a little bit uncomfortable with the fact that I've lived certain experiences with him in my life, and now I'd be going back to maybe get those same experiences. Who knows? You know what I mean? Like, I don't know what the end result of the cloning would be, but it would kind of like scare me a bit, you know?
But it is scary. Like, to be honest, like I said, yeah, because look at the face, but yeah, that scares me. Like you said, like, what if something goes wrong? Like, it just doesn't seem natural. So at the end of the day, I think, like, all jokes aside, no. But if we can make him live forever, now that's a different story.
If you had the option to clone Griff, would you do it?
I don't think I would, but like, at the beginning when he was sick, right? And we didn't know what was going on. If you would have said to me, like, you can have exactly the same thing as him, because the first one's like not doing well, I probably would have rather that than like any alternative.
First of all, it's like morally a bit weird. But second of all, you can't have the same personality.
That's the other thing.
We like his personality. Like, obviously there's like pros and cons. He's not a perfect dog. Like, we still have to train him in a lot of areas, but overall we wouldn't have him if we cloned him.
Yeah, I'd never feel like it's the same dog. I would like, it would be a very good replacement, but it would never be exactly the same thing as what he is.
All right, so now that I know how cloning works, how much it costs, what the process is, I have to say, I don't think I'm 100% sold on it right now. I think that it's a little bit out of my price range. $50,000 is a lot of money, but someday it might be a little bit more affordable, and that might be a little bit more incentivizing to dish out the cash for a Waffles 2.0. At the same time, if they can get to a point where, you know, the clone is a little bit more accurate, where it's the personality, not just the look of the dog that you're getting, that could also influence my decision. It could also change my mind if they can get Waffles at a point in her life where she already is her. Like, if I can get her as a copy of what she is right now, that would also factor into my decision. Now, of course, there is a part of me that also feels like it's a little bit selfish to want to bring her back just for my own pleasure. Even though it isn't necessarily her, it makes me feel good about the fact that there's a version of her that's back in my life. Who knows? The next 10 years, 20 years could change the way we think about pets. But hey, that's me. What do you think? Are you for or against pet cloning? Let us know in the comments below. And while you're at it, hit that subscribe button so you never miss an episode of Technality. See you next time.